Okay, for this topic on pie charts, right? You look at the question, okay? This pie chart shows the number of balloons given out at a carnival in a day. So, obviously from a pie chart, you know that which is the color, which colored balloons, right? It's actually the most popular colored balloons. Blue, right? How do you know? Because 400, right? Other than the numerical value 400, what other information is there to tell you that blue is the most popular? Wait, Jingkai. Okay, the blue color, right, is the biggest sector, right? Correct? Okay, because when you have been inactive for too long, they'll lock you up for security purposes. Okay, anyway, you know that this blue is the most popular because it occupies the biggest sector, right? Yeah. You know what's the meaning of sector, right? Yeah. I explained the word sector to you. This is one of the mathematical terms that you need to know. You cannot say blue is like what Jingkai described, okay? You must use the word sector, okay? Blue occupies the biggest sector, right? Yes? No. The correct mathematical term is sector. No, cannot use section. There's no other word. There's only one word, sector. This one, they go by the... we are not looking at angles here. Yes, in a way, yes. You can also see that it has the biggest angle. Okay, because it has obtuse angle. Yes, true. So... which color was the most popular? Very simple. I don't need to go through. You don't need to do it. You can do it on your own. So, which color was the least popular from the figure? You can immediately say, see, what color is that?
Red.
Red. Okay, very good. Okay. And then, how many balloons were given out altogether? You can actually add up, right? Okay. 1,000 and? Can you just write the answer 1,050 here? Or are you supposed to show me working? Okay, I expect to see working. Okay, I need to see 400 plus 250 plus 250 plus 150. Okay, children, before we move on to the next question. Okay. Please take note that when the moment you look at this, you must know that these two angles are the
same.
Because it's 250 and 250, okay? So these two angles are the same, right? Let's move on to the next question. I do not know if it's one quarter. I'm quite certain it's not one quarter. If you think that it's one quarter, you are wrong. Okay, because if you tell me that the total is 1,050, I know for certainty that it's not one quarter. Okay? So please do not estimate the angle. Do not estimate the angle. You won't know whether it's 90 degrees or not. You cannot measure the angle for a pie chart. I say again, all these are not drawn to scale. Okay? Please do not measure the angle for a pie chart. It's not drawn to scale. And please do not assume it looks like 90 degrees, so it's one quarter. If they put a 90 degree sign, then it's different. Okay, question two. Some pupils were asked to pick their favorite spot. Each pupil picked only one spot. The pie chart represents their choices. Okay, which spot was the most popular? Do you think that is basketball more popular or soccer more popular?
Soccer.
I heard some people say basketball, some people say soccer. Okay, how do we show the working for it? We must make it into fraction with common what? Yes, fraction with common denominator. In this case, what's the common denominator? Can we? 15. Okay, so I have 6 over 15 and 5 over 15. Please do not just estimate. Do not estimate. I need to see working. Okay, so you must show me your working here. 2 over 5 equals to 6 over 15. And 1 third equals to 5 over 15. So you know that soccer is the most popular. Yes, Wendy? Unless you one look at it, you know that 2/5 is bigger than 1/3, then you do it. Okay? Right, yes, Colin G?
Can we just put like the equalization
of
like the pie chart there?
No, you have to write it at part A. Yeah. No need. You can do it mentally. Okay, next part. What fraction of the pupils like tennis? Okay, before we move on, the whole pie chart adds up to how much, Aisha? Do you hear what she say?
Yeah, yes. One hole.
The whole pie chart adds up to?
One hole.
Okay, so in order to know what fraction of the pupils like tennis, you need to do some working as well. 1 whole minus 1/5 minus 1/3. And -2/5. And when you use a calculator, what do you get? 1 over 15. Okay, so fraction 1 over 15. Now, given that there are 75 pupils, so you know that this is actually 1 over 15, and this is actually 3 over 15. Correct? So I managed to make all of them into common denominator of 15, right? Yes or no?
Yeah.
So you can see that 6 plus 5, 11, 11 plus 3, 14, 14 plus 1, 15.
Yeah.
Okay, so you know that all together, the whole pie chart is how many units, Colin Al? 15 units, right? And Ernest, please give me the equation. So 15 units equals to 75. I want to find how many pupils like basketball. Basketball is how many units?
Five
units, right? So you can just divide by?
Three.
In which you'll get 25, right?
Yep.
Okay, yes. Okay, another way, very good way as well, Yongqian suggested. Why don't we just use the fraction? I think that's the better answer. Okay, you use the fraction 1/3, right? Because the fraction for basketball is 1/3, right? Just use 1/3 multiplied by 75. I think this is an even better answer. Personally, I think that this is an even better answer. Okay? Please take note, I do recognize better answers. Sometimes when I reject your answer outright, it's because it's not better. Okay? You know that some of you keep approaching me and I keep rejecting you. It's really a poor answer.